The week before, the British movement held its first national march. The organisers had expected 2,000 demonstrators, but in the event, the police heavily outnumbered the turnout of only 600. And although there were all the familiar trappings, the flags and banners, and there were some menacing figures, the bulk of the marchers were little more than schoolchildren. One man who has, over many years, traced the varied fortunes of Nazi organizations and sympathizers in Britain is Dr. Jacob Gewirtz.
The Nazis in the 1920s and 1930s built up their power structure precisely with this kind of displaced youth, which had no place to go, which was disgruntled, angry, and they gave them a very powerful means of expression. I can't see it catching on in Britain. Some of these kids' fathers fought in the war against the Nazis. I can't see it developing a kind of a mass movement. But it's bad enough as is, because it makes life unlivable for the ethnic minorities who happen to, unfortunately, live in the areas where they operate.
The one British movement member who agreed to talk did so only on condition that we changed his voice. He was frightened he'd be beaten up if he were recognised.
Well, I can imagine what'll happen. Seen it happen to some others. I don't want it to happen to me.
When did you join the British movement?
About a year and a half ago. Going on for 2 years ago.
And why did you join?
I was just out one night drinking and someone comes after me and said, "Do you want to come somewhere?" Just went to the meeting. When I went, listened, it made sense.
Did they suggest you could do anything directly against the people they said were responsible for the problems?
They never exactly said. They went a roundabout way about it.
But you understood what they meant?
Yeah.
And what did they mean?
Go and beat a few people up. That's what it all boiled down to, but they were saying it in a nicer way.
But you think that's what appeals to a lot of youngsters?
Most of the dim ones, yeah. All the ones that got a bit of brain sort of keep out of the fighting bit and do the organising. The rest just get used.
Who is the violence directed against?
Well, some of the British movement don't like Jews, some don't like Catholics or Protestants. Some of them don't like coloureds, so it's checking it out of people, like, eight different types of people.
But you think it's an organisation for people who hate other groups of people, basically?
Yeah, that's it.
And who do you hate particularly?
Blacks.
You think the British movement enables you to do something about that?
Yeah, and they organise it for you as well. You know, you just don't go out and kill someone, batter someone. No, they organise it.
The British movement deny that they organise their members to attack other people. But many of the attacks on blacks and other members of minority groups have involved British movement members. And as the aftermath of their London march shows, violence often erupts anyway.
Have you seen any serious incidents of violence?
Yeah.
Who was the victim?
Well, I don't go on nothing except black ones, because I don't like blacks. So they asked me to go on blacks. So I go on the black ones.
What sort of weapons are being used?
Mostly fists and boots. But sometimes other things get used.
Like what?
Like whatever's lying on the floor. Big sticks. A hammer's been used, but only once.
And how serious are the injuries?
Well, they're usually bad. If any of the British movement gets hurt, more happens to the whoever doing it. So they say if he got his little finger broke or something, they'll break his legs or something like that.
Did you ever go away on a training course?
Yeah.
Do you recall where that was?
Bodmin Moor. And some of the instructors were in the army.
Do you think there are people in the British movement who would be capable of using weapons if they had them?
Yeah. There's a lot of them in the Territorial Army, and I think there's some on the Regular Army, that type of thing. And all the younger ones now, the trying to encourage them to join the cadets, you know. The army cadets. They're taught on the rifle range and things like that.
What about political education? Did you receive any political message at all?
They start about the English, and then you gradually work on to Nazi Germany. And then after a while it's just Nazi Germany, about how good he was and what he did for them. How good he would have been if he'd have won the war, that type of thing.
Are you encouraged to wear swastikas and give the Nazi salute?
On Adolf Hitler's birthday, you do. Turn up in SS uniform.
What do you think of the leaders of the British movement who are putting kids like this onto the streets for violent purposes?
They're only into what they can get out of it themselves, mostly. All I can say about it is what I think. Just use people.
Do you think they should be taken seriously?
Yeah, very.
Why is that?
Well, they've had... been going over to Germany, to Frankfurt. They went over to America to see the Klan, and the Klan come over here. They've been to Ireland, they've been to Holland, they've been to Germany, and they're gradually getting more involved with it, all the different countries. They're all the fascists in the different countries. We've all got different names, we're all the same, really.
So you think the British movement has links with terrorist organisations in Europe?
The ones who... what happened in Paris, yeah, because I know some of the BM who knew one of them. There was a lot of talk. He was with them one night, and they meet in Brussels a lot.
But you believe this is all true, do you? Not just fantasy?
No, not fantasy.
The danger is that in times of great stress, economic problems, more people could be sucked into this very simple, so-called simple solution to all our problems. The basic problem is, what they would say, with the black community or the Jews. And when people get hungry, they search for very extreme solutions. And I think therein lies the danger.
What do you think the average youngster makes of all that?
I don't know. I don't think they're really into it. It's just something they go through. Most of them will leave, but some don't.
Do you think that youngsters who like the idea of a bit of street violence really understand the politics behind it?
No. Half of them haven't got a clue. They're just being used.
But there are no real people joining at all. And moreover, they have no credibility. A kid with a shaven head who drapes himself in a Union Jack is really not going to make much impact on public opinion. A gang of thugs marching down the street shouting, "Jesus was a wog," you know, are really not going to make any impact on public opinion.
So why do you think the British movement are bothering to recruit skinheads?
Because they can't get anybody else.